It may be a new year, but did I drop the ball on my 2023 collecting goals? Stay tuned. What's going on, comic friends? It's Ryan, the Colossus Collector, and thank you once again for stopping by my channel. A new year, a new video. I'm happy to finally get back to shooting some videos for the channel, shooting some content. I hope you all had a really awesome holiday season, a happy new year, and I definitely had a great Christmas and holiday season. I unfortunately, though, right after Christmas, I started actually feeling it on Christmas, but it was all good, but right after Christmas I got sick, and I've been sick kind of for the last week and a half to 2 weeks. I wanted to shoot a bunch of content between Christmas and New Year's, and then even right after New Year's, but I just didn't have the energy, didn't have the voice for it. Today I'm finally starting to really feel like I've turned the corner, got my voice back, got my spring in my step, so to speak. So happy to finally be able to do my 2023 comic goals recap video for you guys to kind of show you how 2023 went for my collecting goals. And I mean, if you've been watching the channel, you probably have an idea of where this video is going to go. I did not drop the ball on 2023, despite the fact that we are now in a new year. So let's now go through all my comic goals, my main comic goals for 2023, and my side quest goals for 2023, and see how I did. So first we'll go over my 2023 comic goals, and started off with Submariner number 1 from May 1968. And if you saw my previous goal video earlier in the year, I did nail this one very early on in January 2023, and then got it graded and it came back a 7.5, so a really big checked off comic for my goals this year. Next on the list was Iron Man number 1 from 1968, but I quickly changed this on my goal list to X-Men number 94 from 1975, because I had a great opportunity to buy this very comic in a 7.0 CGC grade, and just super excited to get it. This would have been on my comic goal list for 2024, but managed to get it in 2023, so quickly swapped it out for that Iron Man one. Next on my goals list was Marvel Premiere number 1, and I actually checked this off twice this year. I got one in a CGC 5.0, which I'm actually giving away once I hit 1,000 subscribers on this channel. But then I got a raw copy as well, which I ended up grading and getting a 6.0 in, which I wasn't super excited about, but did check it off the list this year. Next up, we have X-Men number 12, the first appearance of the Juggernaut. And like the Submariner number 1, I got this one very early in the year from Heritage Auctions, and then also got it graded and came back a beautiful 4.5 when I had thought it was a 2.5, which is what was stated on the Heritage Auction. So a huge win early on in the year. Next up was X-Men 101 from June 1976, the first appearance of the Phoenix, a beautiful Dave Cockrum X-Men cover. And I luckily got this in a 6.5 CGC grade, also another one I got early in the year, and really happy to have it in the collection. And finally, my sixth and final main comic goal for 2023 was Giant Size X-Men number 1 from February 1975, the first appearance of Colossus, my favorite X-Men character. Also the second appearance of Wolverine, the first appearance of Storm, Nightcrawler, and Thunderbird. This really kicked off the Claremont era of X-Men, and it's my holy grail comic, and I'm happy and proud to say that I got this one midway through the year in the summertime from Nefarious Comics in Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. And I'm so excited to have this one in a 5.5 CGC grade.
It's really the centerpiece of my collection, and I'm just so happy I was able to check this one off the list this year. So in addition to my big main comic goals for the year, I also created some smaller goals called my side quests for 2023. And this was inspired by my buddy Black Crown Comics, a fellow Canadian who had this idea on IG, and I totally stole it from him. So my side quest goals consisted of 12 books, starting with Submariner number 8 from 1968, a beautiful black Silver Age battle cover with Thing and Namor, and happy to say that I got this one mid-year, and happy to add it to my Submariner run. Next up was another beautiful black battle cover, Fantastic Four number 112, and happy to say that I got this in a 7.5 off of eBay. Great purchase, great pickup. Next up was Marvel Premiere number 2 from 1972, and this I needed for my Warlock run, and I'm happy to say that I got this one as well, and really love this book. Next up, another book for my Warlock run. This is Strange Tales number 179. This is also the first appearance of Pip the Troll, and keeping with the trend and theme of this video, managed to get this one and check it off the list. Next up, we've got Uncanny X-Men number 255, and this one doesn't have any key significance other than the fact that it helps me fill out my Claremont X-Men run, and happy to say that I checked this one off the list as well and helped me complete that 94 to 300 Claremont portion of my X-Men run. Next up, we've got X-Men 33, a beautiful juggernaut Silver Age cover that I need for my X-Men run 1 to 300, and happy to add this one early on in the year. Absolutely love the colors that pop off this one. Next up, we've got Submariner number 19 from 1969, right on the tail end of the Silver Age, and I love the covers in this Submariner run, especially this one. So had this as a side quest and got it early on in the year. I absolutely love this cover. Another cover I absolutely adore, Man-Thing number 1 from 1974, the first Man-Thing solo title, as well as the second appearance of Howard the Duck, and happily got this earlier in the year, but also sent it to CGC. It came back with a disappointing 6-0, so definitely going to want to upgrade it in the future. Next up, a book I need for my Alpha Flight run that I'm putting together. This is Alpha Flight number 12 from 1984, and this is The Death of Guardian, and I'm happy to say that I picked this one up in the wild this year, and it's one of my favorite Alpha Flight books. Next up, another Alpha Flight book for my run, number 33 from 1986. And this is the first appearance of Lady Deathstrike, an important villain in the X-Men world tied to Wolverine. And also found this one while hunting in the wild. It's kind of the goal for the Alpha Flight run, to find all those books in the wild, so got this one there. Next up, a big ASM book, Amazing Spider-Man 361 from 1992. This is the first appearance of Carnage, and was able to get this one mid-year and then grade it just in the last couple months, and it came back a beautiful 9.8. That was a great moment and a real highlight purchase and pickup for 2023. And finally, I have Iron Man number 282 from 1992, the first appearance of War Machine, an awesome 90s Copper Age cover, and picked this one up mid-year. And I'm currently using this as part of a little bit of a project that I will release a video about in the coming months. So look out for that, but happy to have that as part of the PC.
So there you have it, my 2023 comic goals, my 2023 side quest goals. I came, I saw, I conquered 2023. And then some. Like I said, if you've been watching my channel, I went way beyond my comic goals in 2023. Much to my wallet chagrin, added a ton of huge keys to my collection. So it was a really fun, awesome, exciting year of collecting comic books, and I'm just really pleased and happy that I could get those books, that I could share them with you here on YouTube and also on Instagram. And thank you so much for coming along the journey for me. So now it's 2024 and it's time for a new direction, a new set of goals for this new year. And in my next video, I will take you through my thinking, my new way forward in my comic collecting career or hot pastime. So excited to share where things are headed, where I'm planning to go with this year of 2024. So stay tuned for that video. It's going to drop in the next week. And if you liked this video, why don't you check out some of my recent CGC submissions, a modern and a vintage one, just at the end of the year. And until next time, keep collecting.